What's up, world? Team OBG in the house.
Hey, YouTubers. So tonight we're vlogging about No Fuck Foreplay. It's just what the title says. No Fuck Foreplay. Foreplay doesn't always have to lead to sex.
Right.
So there are things that you can do to stimulate your partner without actually fucking your partner physically, but you can definitely mentally fuck them.
Yes.
So, babe, what are your views on No Fuck Foreplay?
Well, my views on No Fuck Foreplay is a lot of people got the game twisted. A lot of people think that foreplay only consists of body stimulation. Tits, sucking on the neck, kissing on the arms, the whole body. Yeah, that's foreplay. But mental foreplay is totally different.
What's your ideal of mental foreplay, right?
My idea. How
would you mentally fuck me?
How I mentally fuck her. Text message throughout the day. Telling her how much I adore her, what I love about her. Discussing previous things from the previous night or the day that we spent together. Send little messages like, oh, babe, I love the way you did this. Or thank you for the meal. You got to make sure you thank your partner. For a woman, that means a whole lot. Little things mean a whole lot. Right, babe?
Definitely. I definitely love those messages of admiration, appreciation. I get the motor running. I'm like, okay.
Right. Then after you send some sweet, after a few little sweet text messages, then you want to send some semi-freaky. Get the mind stimulated, perk the body a little bit. Yeah,
definitely perks the body a whole lot of it. Depending on what you say, choose your words wisely. You know your partner, so you know what's gonna turn them on. You know those keywords and those hot words that are gonna touch their hot spots without you actually touching their hot spots. These are things that keeps the spark going. We also do little things like inboxes
as if we don't know each other,
right? As if we're someone else, so. And it kind of, it's a little flirtatious thing because we live together, we know that we're involved with someone. So for those that need that outside kick, I need somebody else to be interested in me or show me that extra attention, that's one way to show your partner that extra attention.
Well, babe, I don't really need that extra attention. It's just a mental stimulation for me. So we can walk around the house all night inboxing each other, and she'll say, who the fuck you inboxing? I'm like, nobody, or none of your business. I'll ask her the same thing. And we kept that up for about a year. We do the secret little, hey, I haven't heard from you in a while. So we did a little, I haven't heard from you in a while. How are you? Sitting side by side. At the same time, hiding it from each other that we're inboxing each other. Yeah.
Yeah, like, oh, that's nice. You must have been busy with your girl, huh? That's sweet. Some fuck your bitch type
right
shit.
And then we'll ask each other, what is it that your girl is not doing for you that keeps you interested in me? You keep your girl lifted up, you know what I'm saying? Because you got to remember, you're still talking to your woman.
Please don't out of pocket.
Don't say the wrong shit.
don't get out of pocket, because remember, it's still her.
That's right. So you got to say, well, she does everything, but tell me what you can do for me to stimulate me.
That starts that extra conversation. Oh, okay, well, your girl this, that. Sometimes I call her girl lame. Me. But I can say that about me. She can't say that. But I can say that because it's me that I'm talking about.
Right.
So that's fine. And back to the point. There's nothing wrong with physical foreplay. You can start physical foreplay. Sometimes physical foreplay will get you there too.
That's right.
Doesn't mean it has to lead to sex. But you can touch or rub certain spots on your partner. Kiss them here or there.
Right.
You know, just get them started. You know, if they're in the kitchen cooking, like, I love when she comes behind me and kisses that. Is that right there? Yeah. Right there on the back. Or right there behind my neck. So it's the little things that turn your partner on. Doesn't have to be, oh, let me rub on your booty.
Right. Also asking your woman or your partner, man, female, men like that too, how their day is going in a certain kind of way that's stimulating foreplay. Because that means you're concerned. How are you feeling? What did you eat for lunch? How's your day?
How's your sleep?
There you go.
You know, how are you feeling when you woke up? You know, kind of gauge your partner's mood through the day. And you can sometimes, since they may be having a bad day, so send that message. Oh, did you know I adore you? Did you know that I adore this about you? Did you know right. that I find you absolutely sexy when you do?
Yeah.
I love when you touch me like this. Let your partner know what you like that they do.
Right.
That also gives them that mental stimulation. So it doesn't always have to be, ooh, hey, you know, the usual, let me suck on your this.
Let me touch on your that. Because trust and believe me, when you do a certain form of mental foreplay, doesn't mean you have to go home that night or that day and get buck wild. I mean, it works. It's happened before a whole lot of times. But sometimes when you do that foreplay for days and days and days, that just kind of gets a buildup. And then your mind starts thinking of when your partner touches you or when your partner kisses you. So that way when it happens, yeah, it happens. Like, real big.
Pow. Extremely big.
Yeah.
Get the juices flowing.
You so nasty. Ooh, you so nasty.
Yes. Okay, so, and also with foreplay, this one likes control. She likes bossy chicks.
You're talking about physical foreplay right now.
She likes to be bossed around. She nasty. Well, I mean, that's something that we both kind of like. If I'm walking down the hallway, get my ass up against the wall and kiss me. You gotta go nowhere else after that. But that's gonna have me. Yeah. If I'm walking down the hall, grab my ass.
Bam. She got a lot of ass.
No, I don't.
Shit.
I don't have ass. But. Grab my ass. Pull me back by my waist. You know, it just kind of depends on what you and your partner likes. Again, like I said, you know your partner. You know their hot spots. You know their key spots. That's going to make them feel a certain type of way. And if you're in a new relationship and you're not quite sure what those spots are, try a couple things.
Figure that shit out. You got to, your partner's body is your playground. You know, a lot of people like to go to Six Flags, Hurricane Hall, but back in the day, we went wild. Yeah. Even for you little young bucks like to go to Chuck E. Cheese and shit like that.
I still like to go to Chuck E. Cheese. Well, I'm old as hell.
No, you're not old. But anyway, you know what I'm saying? You got to explore. It's okay if you hit a spot or you kiss something that your partner doesn't really like. You won't know that until you try it. Yeah, so make your partners, your girl, woman, boy, man's body your personal playground. Because after all, that is your body. It belongs to you. If you're in a relationship, you belong to them, they belong to you. Besides belonging to God, He comes first. But anyway, so if you know, like I know my baby's hot spots, sometimes I'll hit those, sometimes I won't. Because if I know all her hot spots, then my job is to find or create, yeah, big word, another hot spot. Some areas that I've touched that she may have not been touched in before, touched on before, vice versa, yeah. You know what I'm saying? It kind of make you like, oh shit, like that's new. You know, don't just stick with the same old, same old. You got to be creative. You got to adore and enjoy what you're doing. doesn't always have to lead to oral stimulation or fucking. You know what I'm saying? You just
no fuck foreplay.
If you're with somebody and the only way that you can have an orgasm is from penetration or oral sex, you with the wrong motherfucker. Because this one right here, I know how to stimulate her without doing either one of those. Vice versa. So it's a learning process. Every day you learn something different, because as women, as lesbians, every day is not the same. One day I may love for her to suck on my neck. The next day I just might want her to kiss on my back. So it's about knowing your partner, knowing your significant other, your girl, your man, whatever you want to call it, and taking pride in knowing that when you kiss this spot or when you touch this spot, you know for sure that you're going to satisfy them. All right, babe?
I agree.
You agree? So, I mean, it's like, you know, like, whatever y'all like to do, then do it. But don't press on it too much. You know what I'm saying? Some people get in one spot and you get that reaction and you tend to stay there. It's okay to hit it and raise up off of it and come back to it a little later on. Because while you're hitting something else, or while you're kissing something else, you're so nasty, or while you're kissing something else, that hot spot is secretly whispering, come back over this way. Or the mind is working like, oh my God, when is she going to touch that again? Or when is he going to touch that again? Just kind of keep it open. Keep it flowing. Be free. You know, nerves get the flowing. We've been together forever. But we still both get nervous. We still get the butterflies. We still feel like it's our first date most of the time. Or our first time being active. Control your woman. It's okay to control your woman in the bedroom. Sometimes you can be timid. Sometimes it's all right to be. What's my word? Sometimes it's okay to be subservient. Sometimes it's okay to be aggressive. Sometimes giving, if you're always the aggressor, if that's what you into, then that's what's up. That's what it is. But for any relationship, anybody likes to be controlled to a certain point. And if they don't, then you're dealing with a control freak. I like to be in control a lot of the times, but I also like when she flipped the script and controlled me. I like bossy. I like the bossiness. Tell me what you want me to do. Tell me to lay my ass down and shut the fuck up. Don't say one word. Did I ask you to touch me? Did I ask you to move? Yeah, I like that. I'm going to flip it on you now. Bam!
Yeah, that happens sometimes. She does like that, but that sometimes backfires on me a little bit.
That's because I flipped the script. You know what I'm saying? I can't let you have too much control. I try. The Lord is still working with me. I'm sorry, Lord. I ain't using the Lord's name in vain. I ain't being blasphemous. But I'm just saying, you know, yeah. yeah, sometimes it's okay to flip the script. Let her control. Let he, she control. And then flip the script.
But you ain't always got to flip the script. It's okay to be submissive and leave it at that.
That's the word I was looking for a while ago. Submissive.
It's okay to be submissive and just leave it at that. Your partner got control, and when they done, shit, let them know. Oh, you did that. Yeah. So it's okay to release that control as well. You don't always have to flip it. Flipping it is very, that's hot though. Because I'll give in like a motherfucker quickly. Very quickly. But she cheats when she does that, y'all. I swear she's cheating.
That's neither here nor there.
Oh.
Gary with the teeth. Yeah. I'm just saying. It's okay.
I got some wine up. But yeah, it's cool to be submissive and controlling. It's okay to play both sides of the fence.
For you lesbians. Men, don't play both sides. You be the man.
Men, it's okay to give your woman a little control.
She can have a little control, but when you say both sides, but that's totally different for lesbians.
I ain't seen.
That's totally different. It's only so much, and so far she can go. She know that.
Everybody should
be. I'm just saying, it's only so far. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm just, that's just what that is.
See, this is one of those moments when you have to, shut the fuck up. Don't say nothing.
And I'm quiet.
Yeah.
But anyway, we're about to pause this video and we're going to move on to the next subject on foreplay. We basically going to turn this into just a relationship session, sex session, foreplay session, whatever you want to call it. So next we're going to come back and we're going to talk about some real shit. We're going to get kind of down and gritty with it. So if you're 18 and under,
go to bed,
turn off our channel. If you're judgmental,
go to bed. No, if you're judgmental, have a drink and then take your judgmental ass to bed. Because you might just need to release a look. You know what? Don't go to bed. You might need to watch this.
And for y'all that's having trouble in the bedroom, or trouble with everyday life on how to keep your partner happy, in that way, more than one way to keep your partner happy. But right now, we're talking about foreplay.
No, fuck foreplay.
But I think in this next session, we're going to talk about fuck foreplay. Bam.
Ooh. I'm gonna get ready.
You're nasty.
Okay, so we're back.
Part three.
Maybe I thought you were starting this one.
No, you're gonna start this one off. Go ahead. You got it.
My bad. So, we ended the last session of this foreplay. Foreplay. But these are things where my baby is supposed to be down to the
nitty-gritty means like getting down to it. When it's time to get down to it.
Get down.
Put your panties down.
There are a lot of ways to get down to your partner.
No second guessing. Be confident in what you're doing.
Confidence is key. Way.
Start from top to bottom, or bottom to top. It's like a little toes. That's what you're into.
That's what she's into.
Kiss a little earlobes, both sides. Ah.
Like that.
Yeah. Give each side equal opportunity. Like focus more on the right side.
You want to be on one side.
You feel neglected. You know what I'm saying? But when you do what you're doing, be confident your main focus is to make sure your partner is reaching their sexual peak. No hesitation, no giving up. My thing is, I want you to beg for it. I'm gonna hear something and back up off of it. Tell me to come back. Tell me right here. Tell me right there.
Right now. Shit.
It's okay to hold a head for oral sex. It's okay to hold a hips for penetration. It's okay to guide and direct. Speak. Verbally state what you need, what you want at that particular moment. Right?
I mean, some of y'all might not be into that, but hey, shit's a turn on. You call me out my motherfucking name, grab my hair. Ladies, sometimes when you mess up at, you give up that fantasy that thing with somebody else. Sometimes I may be timid, oh, this is my baby, I don't want to do my baby like that. Okay, that's cool. Tonight I'm not your baby. Tonight I'm that chick that you saw that turned you on a little bit. I'm still that same one that walked around the house in the heels that did that little stripper skip.
Yes, girl.
But I ain't baby at that moment.
Right.
I'm okay with grab my hair and, hey, I'm okay with some of y'all be tripping. Oh, she called me bitch.
Don't nobody know you calling her a bitch, but you and her.
Yeah,
I'm gonna shot video it.
Be a slut, nigga. You know what I'm saying? Shit, give her that fantasy, create that illusion of someone else.
And it's okay to make your tongue feel lesbian. Sing a song with your tongue. Whether you're doing oral sex or touching any other part of the body. And you can make your tongue sing the words to a song. That's for us. That's what you need. You know what I'm saying?
Pause time. Bam.
Okay. So, basically, don't be afraid. Get in there. Do what you do, man. Please your women.
You're right.
Please your woman.
No, in your mind.
That was right for some
reason. Y'all see how that illusion, she just forgot just that quick. She ain't got more. She
but I'm saying, but you're my inbox. You're my at home. So it's different. But she's absolutely correct. Please your woman, men. Women, please your woman. Vice versa. Women, please your men. You're a man.
Girl, y'all better not have no men. Just kidding. Do what you do.
I know what I'm saying. For you bisexual relationships, y'all might need that. You know what I'm saying? But there's no bisexuality going on in this area. But I do know how to do both things in every way. Right? Penetration. A bad bitch. It's a bad bitch, but no penetration. You know what I'm saying? In certain kind of ways, but we won't discuss that with y'all.
Yeah. So it's definitely okay to do whatever pleases your partner. That's your partner. A lot of y'all say, I don't do this, I don't do that. There's no way in hell I would do this. Okay, that's fine. There's somebody else that will. So you gotta remember that. That's your partner. That's who you're with. That's who you're going to be with. So it's okay to do what you need to do to keep them happy.
Right.
To please them. Maybe if you have to put a wig on, become somebody different. Outfit.
That's okay, as long as you're happy with the original version. It's okay to do a little acting. You know what I'm saying?
Role play.
Role play. Good thing. Trust me. when you've been together for a long time, you have to know how to stimulate each other. We're not saying this is what it takes to make a successful relationship. But if you want a hot, steamy relationship, this is our advice to you.
You don't have to follow said tips again. You know, everything is not for everybody.
Right.
So your steps or how you might do or what your partner likes or what you like is definitely going to be different. So just follow or do whatever you feel. But you can't get into that mode and that mindset of what you won't do.
Emotionally. Yeah.
You can definitely feed into all those to give your partner what they need. Because everybody needs all those things to have a well-balanced relationship. Sometimes we think that just the physical is enough to please our partner. There's nothing wrong with that, but there are other ways to please your partner as well. And for lesbians, as women, we need that on both sides. Some feminine women forget that you're dumb, you're aging, you're stubborn. You forget that they're women, and you're so focused on them pleasing you. You don't worry about pleasing them.
I'm aggressive as hell. I love to be in control. But again, like I said earlier, I like when she's aggressive. I like when the script is flipped. I love it.
So don't forget that. Don't leave your partner out. Don't leave them hanging. It's okay for you to get what you need, but just don't forget that they need that too. I'm going to speak to that on males as well, for you females who are hetero relationships. I'm sure your dude likes that too. I'm sure he likes some attention, you know, special attention or whatever as well. So you can't be a selfish lover, which is really the main key.
Speak better.
You have to remember the same things that you like, they like. The same thing that feeds you emotionally, you need to feed them emotionally.
And for you women that's with men, don't get it twisted. They got nipples. They like that shit to be sucked and touched. Turn that ass out. You gotta stick your finger in a booty hole. If your nigga like that, that's some different shit. But hey, each to their own.
He might like that. That's
don't,
his thing.
Don't mean nothing. You know what I'm saying? Don't mean he flipping the script or whatever the case may be. It just means he like what he likes. So right now we have our 21-year-old daughter standing at the door looking at
us. She just stepped out her booty hole. Talking about the booty hole. Yes, whatever it may take, ladies.
So women, know how to please. Whatever you're with, make sure you know how to please whatever you're with. Don't be afraid of the body. It's just body parts. Women, lesbians, it's just a pussy. Heterosexual couples, it's just a dick. It's just a pussy. What are you afraid of? It cannot kill you. It cannot harm you. Well, some dicks and pooches can harm, but that's on you to know what's going on inside. Just make sure you don't focus on the main parts, which are breasts, what the world thinks. Breasts, ass, pooches. It's not all about that. You know, I like to be kissed on the forehead. I like to kiss on the forehead. And when you kiss a woman on the forehead, that's a totally different effect.
Some of endearment.
There you go.
So you can't forget other words like affection, endearment, appreciation.
And before you reach your sexual peak, before you climax, it's okay to say, I love you. Or express to that person how much you love them. It's gonna make that nut even bigger. I'm sorry. It's gonna make that climax even bigger.
Definitely makes it bigger. So there's nothing wrong with expressing how you feel in that moment.
Don't be a pussy. You know what I'm saying? If you in it,
don't be a pussy while fucking a pussy.
You know what I'm saying? If you want them to fuck you, say fuck me. If you want to tell them to stop being so goddamn rude, you tell them to stop being so goddamn rude. Me,
pleasure
y'all had that
baby. But pain is not always pleasure. So make sure that they remember that. Make sure that they treat your body the way that it needs to be treated in their moment. Not all sessions are meant to be make love sessions. Some of y'all forget that.
We got make love sessions. We got straight fuck sessions.
So it's okay to straight fuck it.
And it's okay to just be so into each other. We just want to make love. Hallelujah.
Woo woo.
Woo woo. Woo woo.
It's okay to be sensual. It's okay to have slow fuck moments.
It's okay to be aggressive.
Submissive.
It's okay to be straight fuck moments. You understand what I'm saying? Pull the hair. Rub the face. Oh, you're so beautiful. Whatever the case is. Ah! But that's how it goes.
Yeah, that's it.
And this is that team.
Moby G.
Moby G.
And we out, YouTubers. Bye, bitches.
Remember what we say it. And for your motherfuckers that's frowned up at this video, fuck you. Go get fucked. And you're going to feel a whole fucking lot better.
Whole lot. Poor team team.
For your homosexual couples, we hope we taught you a few things. For your heterosexual couples, we hope we taught you a few things. We hope we've taught you a few things. I had a few cups of red wine.
Sweet red. Like
sweet red wine. Excuse me. It's freaking nasty right here. But anyway, we're out. Until next time, we hope you enjoyed this video.
Press like. Subscribe. Leave comments. We will definitely read them.
Don't be scared to leave a comment. We want your feedback. You want to talk about me? You want to talk about her? Be careful, motherfucker. I'm a female, but don't get that shit twisted.
If you have some things to add, definitely add those. We'll read those. If you have other topics you would like us to blog about, we'll do that too.
Bam.
Peace out from Moby G.
Next time.